Because I have one uncle who hasn't been back for so long. He's been here and tied up with work. When he actually ordered and when he eat it, he was tearing up. My name is Saskia Dahuri. My soul name is Kelate SG. Kelate, yeah. We are serving Kelantanese cuisine, authentic Kelantanese cuisine. Like we have laksam, we have mee celup and also colek malah. I'm a Kelantanese myself. I was born in Kelantan. My mom is Thai Kelantanese. So this one is actually my mom's recipe. So every state in Malaysia have their own laksa. So we call it laksa Penang, laksa Kedah, laksa. But for Kelantan, the specialty is the roe itself. Okay, so we call it laksam. So laksam is a fish gravy. Laksam roe is rice flour. So laksam is like laksa. Actually, Kelantan have two. They have both. One laksam and one laksa. So this laksam is handmade. We steam the rice flour and all that. We have to roll it and after that we cut it. So that's why it becomes round like that. And another thing about the laksam roll, it's very fragile and the texture has to be correct, you know, because some of it, if you don't get the right mixture, it becomes very chewy. So that one is wrong. Yeah, so people who do this laksam normally is like makcik-makcik in Kelantan, you know, so it's very authentic. Yeah, so that's why I feel like whenever you want to do anything, any business, any products, it has to be something that you know, something that you believe in, you know. Like you can get the recipe online, but definitely it's not going to be the same. Mee celup is like beef noodle, whereby we actually put freshly the noodle and we have also kangkong. So we actually dip it, so we celup inside the boiling water. Yeah, celup is deep inside. So it's like you put in and celup, then you put inside the bowl and put the soup and also condiments. The soup is, you can taste of spiciness, sour, sweet. Sweet comes from the beef broth. All my laksam and mee celup, we don't use oil at all. No oil. The broth actually, if you see some oil, it actually comes from the beef itself. When you put all the four condiments, green chili, ground nuts, chili flakes and also fried garlic, when you mix it together, it's very, very flavorful. Yeah. So this colek malah is actually like fritters. We have veggies inside, anchovies. Our specialty is the sauce. So the sauce is a spicy, there's a sweet taste, spicy taste. When you eat it, there's also ground nuts inside. Yeah, so that's a specialty. So whenever we prepare for colek malah, it has to be deep fried. Yeah, so that's why sometimes people need to wait for a bit because we like to fry it fresh so that when you eat it, it's a different feeling when you eat it hot compared to like those that we pre-cook, you know? Yeah. This food is something that I love. This is something that is from my mom's, my great-grandmother recipes. Yeah, so I feel like I should share this with people in Singapore and not only in Singapore, some Malaysian that is here because of, you know, COVID nowadays. So they miss Kelantanese food, they miss Malaysian food. So that's why they can come over here and then you can taste our food, yeah. Back in Malaysia, I'm an actress myself. So I am so busy normally because shooting will be like from morning till night sometimes. So you have no time to cook at all. But this is my first time like really focusing on cooking, you know, whereby I come down to the stall and then check out every little details. Because what I believe when you want to serve to people, it's like something that whenever you want to serve to your loved ones, your family, so you have to do it correctly. Doesn't matter like who they are. So when you want to do, quality is important. Now because I'm bringing Kelantanese food to Singapore, that's why I want to keep the authenticity of the food, to make sure that it's like original, you know. So this one, I started it at home first actually. So throughout Circuit Breaker, I've done like a couple of times. I've been selling it from home. The response was amazing. Like, I do it only once a week, but people was like ordering like 300 to 400 orders. After that, I was thinking, you know, why not? I feel like Singaporean loves Kelantanese food. So that's when I started. I feel, okay, you know, let's just open up a store. So I like this environment, you know, like it feels like I'm back in Malaysia. Because in Malaysia, there's a lot of gerai, a stall around in Malaysia, you know? So I love that type of food. So that's the reason why I feel like it suits our food as well. Most of the times I'll be here, I'll go table for table and ask them how is it like. Any feedbacks and anything they want to share with us, you know? So they have so many, opinions or suggestions, and hearing from them that they love our food and all, that is the best feeling. Because I have one uncle who hasn't been back for so long. He's been here and tied up with work. When he actually ordered and when he ate it, he was tearing up. Yeah, he was tearing up. He was like, it reminds him of everyone back home. It reminds him of those days when he's like eating the laksam, you know? So that is something that I feel like it's so nice to, it's such a wonderful feeling to hear that from people, yeah. It's not about profits and all. Of course, business, they will talk about profit, but the most important thing, we want people, repeat customers, we want people to talk about our food, you know? So that is very, it's a satisfaction for me, yeah.